Hello everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Chibi Robo. In the last episode, we were up in Jenny's room. Getting more progress done. And this episode, if it ever loads, I will be, day or night time? It's night time. So, we are going to take a slight detour from Jenny's room, and we're going to go do some other things before we do that. I feel like it should be done beforehand, because there's a... I got lots of music, sorry guys. I'm going to put off the bedroom a little bit longer to do some other things that I haven't done yet. Or to put off Jenny's bedroom and do some other things that I feel I should go first. Do some only nighttime things. Alright, so first up on our list of things to do, we are going to head upstairs. I really wish I had a certain thing to get me to the top of the stairs in a much more convenient way than the ladder every time. I'm wondering if the Sandersons ever walk into these things and they're sticking so high up in the air. What if they knock them over because they're being careless? So yes. Anyway, plan for the episode: we're gonna go up onto the parents' bedroom and speak to Mrs. Sanderson now that we've opened up to the path to get there at night. And then, depending on how much time we have left, we're gonna do some stuff in the basement. So let's just climb the stairs. There's Jenny again. I think she's gonna say the same thing as she said last time. But just in case, we're gonna go talk to her anyway. Let's see. Hello. I can't remember if I read that dialogue last time or not. But no need to fear, Jenny. We are on the case, for we are Chibi Robo. We are in the top 10 percentile of Chibis. We're in the top 10 of all 1 million Chibi Robos. If that's all there is. Chibi, get down. So now we have to climb the door. It's convenient that there are all these things that we can climb on and stuff to get to where we need to go. Alright, so be gentle. Apparently me staying on to small passageways is not pop very well on this, I think, because there's a delay. So now we can get inside. We go inside. The bedroom. I really hope I never do that again. The official. What are we gonna do? Looking out the window. Solving your problems. These bills are piling up. On top of that, the electric bill has skyrocketed. He's just hopeless. Well, let us enter the domain that is the woman's bedroom. There's lots of stuff that can go on. There's a frog? What's wrong with you, Robo? Don't you see the corpse over there? The corpse of the frog? What's that? Let's go have a closer look. It looks like a frog, but how horrible. Who could have done such a thing? You think it could have been Teo? No. Yeah, you're right. He already has plenty of food and bones and stuff. But who could have? Huh? This shouldn't be happening right now. Chibi Robo, something's over there! Telly... Didn't they teach you how it's not good to lie? There was something over there. I'm gonna go take a look. Well, you do that. I've got other things to do. There's actually, we could do something with this frog right now, but as of right now, not really much we can do with it because I don't have the right stuff with me. So we're really here to see Mrs. Sanderson. We'll come back and figure that out another time. Hi there, Chibo. Her face is so funny. Hi there, Chibo. How'd you get in here? Did you come to check on me because you were worried about me? What is with her face? Thank you, Chibo. Yeah, we know how to deal with the ladies. Oh, yeah. No, don't think that. She's married. Bad people. Oh, I bet Jenny and her dad asked you to check up on me. Well, since you're here, would you mind keeping me company? I'm balancing our checkbook, but something doesn't add up. I'm exhausted. I wonder if there's a toy receipt I'm missing. I bet he's hiding one somewhere. I asked him about it earlier, and he said... Don't worry, you have all of them. Ha, when it comes to toys, I don't know if I can trust him to have any self-control. Oh, hey. Do me a favor, Chibo. See if you can find a hidden toy receipt. If you find one, bring it back to me. If you do, my husband will have some explaining to do. So yeah, that triggers some stuff that goes on later. So that basically kind of means I think we're done right now. We can do some other stuff in the bedroom. Actually, I don't think we really even can because Mrs. Sanderson is actually here. So we'll come back later. Okay, the bedroom shenanigans will just have to wait. I know you guys are probably all eager, but it's just gonna have to wait. We got plenty of other things we can do in the house right now. Alright, so let's just get on our way out. While I'm up here, I'm gonna go over here. If I can make it, yeah, buddy. There's some stuff over here we can explore since we're... And remember this little shortcut for later. Just remember, old buddy Rim sent ya. You'll need this for some... It'll be helpful for something later. But, if we come up here, behind this big paneling thing up here, there's this. This is really cool. I don't know what kind of purpose it serves, but it's just really, really cool to see all these stars painted in here. So let's take care of this. And after this, we got a few things to do in the basement. That was 500 bucks right there. All right, our destination: the frog ring. Probably shouldn't have did that, but I think we'll be all right. As you can see right there, there's a sunshine sticker. You know what that means? We pop it with the Chibi Blaster. Alright. Turn that off for now. So we can get to our prize. Alright. Alright, it should be high enough. I think you need to fly into there to get in here, but I might be mistaken. Just for the sake of it, we'll turn the thing back on. That way we can just keep it nice, you know? Alright, now we'll float down on our own like this. That way we don't use up as much battery, because it takes more battery to fly horizontally. Alright, now we're gonna aim for over here. I wasn't meaning that, but... See, can I get to this? Oh, there's the Space Scrambler! Those eggs guys we're talking about. Where are the Free Rangers, by the way? I haven't seen them in here in a while. It must be just because Jenny's around. So Junior had to be incapacitated before she was able to do more in the base, to do more with the eggs in the foyer in the nighttime. Alright, so we're about halfway done with what we need to do. It's time for us to get some moving. By the way, is it, hey boys, what's up? Whoa, dodge. Well, that was easy enough. Did you guys hear that noise? I heard like a whoa, whoa, whoa noise. Maybe it was just me. But I thought I heard a noise. So now what we're going to do, because I feel like I should do this before it gets too far along, Captain Plankbeard said something about coming back to hear his story sometime. Well, it's been quite a while. I think we owe Captain Plankbeard story time. I wonder if the great Piku is... Yeah, he's still here. I don't think I want to do anything with him now, though. I'm not really much for gambling.
Oh, hi there, Chibi! It's good to see you, laddie! Been long and long it has!
Yes.
So, you've come to hear this old salt's tale, have you?
Indeed, my good sir.
Alright, send you back. Get ready for a way over tale.
Hold on. I'm here to keep my promise, too.
Oh, hi there, Squidbait! You're looking ship-shaped today!
Squidbait? Squidbait!
Hi, Squidbait! Now simmer down! I'm about to tell ye, happened many years ago, when the world was young.
Loading the flashback. Why, that looks like... It is! It's Moolah.
That fateful day I found at the blue gleaming like a wee lassie's eyes. And the salty scourge of the seas that I was. I decided to seize this shiny treasure for myself. Oh, a pretty treasure it was. However... The Sandersons were so poor, you could hear their bellies rumbling like thunder. Chibi Robo blamed himself for the troubles I did. Every pirate swears to be as evil as a barnacle in the bed. It'd be our code.
I will say, that sounds like code for something. Yes. Evil as a barnacle. Keep that in mind, young... Keep that in mind, I guess. That's saying. I don't know what I'm saying.
I could even steal one measly doubloon. Gah, foul humiliation it was. My wife was unhappy in the bed that night. And as you know, pirates are not evil. Hit up the theme parks. It'd be terrifying. I hid me ship and confined myself in the briny dark old basement. Yar, to Sanderson's be out of Moolah, and can't be buying food. I bet they be... dead!
Huh? Actually, the Sanderson's family is doing just fine. They may not be rich, but they were at least able to buy us. And we're not exactly bargain basement items, if I do say so myself. What you talking about, fool? You were talking to Captain.
Gahar! What's that you be saying? So they'd not have been troubled if I'd claimed to Moolah I found as me own.
I heard that Mr. Sanderson hasn't been working and finances are kind of tight. But if it's just a little, it's not a problem.
Do you know what this means? I'm no longer bound to this dank backwater! There's treasure in this house, laddies. And I means to find it! Where's the mainsail, me hearties? sail.
Don't you need a ship first?
Shiver me timbers! I forgot! I've not a dinghy to me name!
Egad!
I put me ship in dry dock as so to keep her safe, but... me head's full of ogg, and me ship's lost! Here, me only hope, Chibi! I want you to find me ship and bring her home! A pirate in need is a pirate who gets what he wants! That's the pirate's code, you see!
That doesn't seem right somehow.
Don't think so, eh? You fancy yourself a great thinker, don't ya? Me flyin' chum bucket. If you're half as keen as you think, you'll keep your blowhole shut. Pirates are not accustomed to waiting. Now go find the ship!
Yes, sir, Captain, sir. Phew, let's go look for the ship, Chibi Robo. I'll go on ahead and scout around. Well, that was interesting. So from this point on, I really don't know what else to do. Oh, crap. We have enough to fill the rest of the episode, I'd say. This is a pretty decent amount. So let's just, I guess, just go find stuff to clean. And actually, since we got 300 scrap, we can see if we can build a Unilobot. There's a certain one I have my eye on that I would really like to have. Right, as soon as possible. It's gonna make, it'll make things a lot easier for us. Gosh, this takes forever. Gosh, we finally made it to the top of the stairs.
The foyer! The foyer, my friends! Move faster!
Actually, we can feed the fish at night. I forgot about that. I keep forgetting about those fishies. And soon we should see the fruits of our labor with the fish. And if you guys have been more diligent than me, you might have already seen it, because you can feed them once every half day. So basically, once in the day segment and once in the night segment with the cookie crumbs. We may run into some more spiders. Also, I said like either last episode or the episode before that, that spiders only appear in three rooms of the house. The kitchen, the foyer, and the basement. Oh, I was incorrect about that. I forgot to factor in the backyard. The backyard itself also, I think the controller's a little glitchy. But yeah, the backyard, they also appear in the backyard. I haven't been in the backyard in ages, so I don't necessarily know what's going on. I kind of forget about it. I guess technically it's not a room in the house, but it's a location. So those are the four areas of the house that the spiders appear in. I believe they respawn either after every day or every half day. So it's hard to say. We're basically done for the episode, almost. Alright, let's see, where's our crumbs? The bottom. It seems whatever problem I had with my mic seems to be fixed, like I had a few episodes ago. Where it's like, I hear this sound, but I don't hear the sound anymore. Or at least it doesn't show up on Audacity. Alright, now I'm gonna need this, because even though as nice as it is to have honey, I need water. For more stuff than I do honey. So, but I will remember where the honey is. I will remember that. Actually, I'm not even sure what use honey has. I mean, I don't know if this game discriminates between honey and nectar, so it's hard to say. So anyway, let's move on. Maybe I can do a little bit more. With, let's see. Can we go higher? Should be able to. There's something we can do up here if I can actually get up there in time. Come on, baby. Alright, let's go. A trap plug-in! Yeah, I can plug in from there. I wasn't trying to, you dumb idiot. You do me, G. You did, Chan, you do. Keyhole, you forget. I'm not high enough, am I? Oh, you're kidding! You're kidding me! No! I'm not gonna make it up there now, I'm gonna at least adjust the ladder. Are you serious? I am so ticked off. I don't even know why I'm recharging, really. I still have to give it an honest try. Let's just give it a go. I don't have much time. Go, 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 go. I really don't have I'm not gonna make it. There's actually something in that tube thing which I never actually really think about. I don't know if I can make it to. Don't do that, don't do that. That's another thing. And for another time. I'm gonna make it, I'm gonna make it! Oh gosh, no! Oh, that hurts. You should be back to the house, oh yeah. Alright, well that's fine. Alright, so time to accumulate the happy parts and see what happens. We're probably not gonna rank up, I don't expect. Come on. Yep, still 10. And we need 365 more happy points. If we get one happy point a day, we will have enough happy points in a year. But that will do it for this episode of Let's Play Chibi Robo. I thank you all for watching. I hope you all join me for the next episode. Yeah, I shook it up there for you. See you guys next time.